It's time for the main event of the evening. And this contest will be fought over 3 5-minute rounds of professional mixed martial arts in the welterweight division. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our first fighter making his way to the blue corner. From Peterborough, a UFC veteran, he is John the One Maguire!
So here we are, main event time here at Cage Steel 23 at the Sheffield Arena. This is a welterweight bout, and it's brought to you in association with Fenwick's. We've got Sam the Snake Boult in the red corner, the black shorts, booster shorts, and John the One Maguire in the blue corner, the Valetudo bad boy shorts, and off they go. Two fighters we're very familiar with. One in particular, you, Luke Barnett. John Maguire.
Yeah, Mr. Maguire's taught me most of the things I know, and I've been with him for 12 years as a training partner and a very good friend. So I'm definitely going to be biased in this fight. Nice stiff jab to start off from John. Both coming out in the southpaw stance. Realistically, these guys are both formidable grapplers. So that I was waiting for that moment. John looking for the guillotine very quick.
And John spoke to me yesterday, said he's got a... just been given his brown belt in by 10th Planet over there in Vegas, which is a hell of an achievement. There's only a handful of those over here in the UK.
Uses that guillotine very well to get up on top and uses it to sweep his opponent. Yeah, he goes out to Vegas a lot to train. Trains under Casey, Coach Casey, and has just received his brown belt. But this guy, talking about a man who submitted Andy Roberts as a black belt competition maybe 8 years ago by Kimura in about 2 minutes. So this guy's grappling is unreal. And unless you felt it, it's very hard to understand how good his level is.
But then on the flip side, you've got the black belt in Sam Boult.
Very well worked back up to his feet by Sam Boult as well. And yeah, he's a formidable grappler himself. That's why it's so interesting to see what happened. In that little exchange in the guillotine, they both did everything right, and this is where we end.
It's funny because John said he wants to test his brown belt against the black belt of Sam Boult. But Sam Boult is a formidable force, very, very strong, very athletic. But what was great about these two is they're both beautiful human beings as well. They cut weight together. They share the sauna. They came to the weigh-ins together. They were sat chilling out. And now they go to war together. It's one of the beautiful parts of the sport where it is competition and they just want to test themselves on this arena.
Great risk control here from John. Got double risk control on one side. Sam Boult doing the right thing, putting all of his weight on the cage. John looking to take a hook or maybe use that to get him to the canvas. But yeah, that doesn't surprise me, John cutting weight with his opponent. You know, he's a happy-go-lucky guy, enjoys this sport so much, and you know, just loves to compete worldwide, and he's been doing it for so long now. You've got to have that passion to have nearly 40 fights under your belt.
Yeah, record of 26-12. 19 of his 26 wins are by finish, 16 submission, 3 KOs. And you flip that over to Sam Boult, 11 wins, 9 by finish, 7 submissions, 2 KOs.
John dragging it down to the mat there, quite unorthodox, pulling guard almost, but on the back. He's got the butterflies, Sam Boult doing everything great. Very athletic, as you said, flexible in this position as well. John looking to take the back.
Sam Boult back to his feet again, turns inside, that's nice
very
work.
Very strong there from Boult to get where he's at, looking, searching for that guillotine. Gets the neck of Maguire, Maguire goes directly down to the ground. Now Boult in a very strong position.
Looking to take the back, but Maguire reacting to that movement.
Now Maguire can use the cage as his friend to get stand back up to the feet and try and avoid these shots of Sam Boult on top. Sam Boult on top is a nightmare, very strong physically. And looking to use ground and pound, not just the grappling he has.
Yeah.
A lot of pressure from the hips of Sam Boult.
Physical specimen, also trains not only at Sheffield Shoot Fighters, but Fourth Dimension as well down there in Nottingham. Get some good rounds in there. Sam Boult has actually fought in this arena twice already. He's 1-1 in this arena. I was here when he stepped out against Adam Busev, another grappler. Dream came true. That was in July of 2017. Won by arm triangle and actually set that up standing. Dropped to the ground and then finished it on the mat. But this is going to...
Maguire taking a lot of elbows here to the legs. They're going to hurt the IT band, softening him up. But he's really searching for this choke, maybe a dash choke or a guillotine as John tries to come up. But I think John has wrist control, quite hard to see from this position. Very calm in these positions. These guys are veteran, been around a long time. So, you know, John getting now to his feet, but needs to watch the neck.
And also right in the corner there, you've got Jack Mason, as well as John's brother, right?
Yeah, John's brother, Tommy Maguire, and also his jiu-jitsu coach in Fabio Ferrari. He trains out of Impulse BJJ, who will be representing tonight over in Peterborough. Great little gym, and also Mark Day is there as well, another black belt that he trains with regularly. You looking to sweep from the butterfly position. Great work from Maguire to regain the guard and get out of that tough spot. Like I said, Sam Boult on top of you is very tough to control, very strong physically.
Now some hammer fist from Sam Boult coming down.
Foot on the hip from Maguire, controlling that wrist, looking for a triangle. Good posture from Boult.
Boult reacted well there.
Let's see if Maguire tries to stand up here, has a bit of space.
Sam Boult just working those thighs. He's elbowed one side of John Maguire's, now he's kicking the other. Jumping attack there from Sam Boult. Athletic stuff into the half guard of John Maguire. That knee shield across the belly of Sam Boult there. First round in the books.
First round. Boult getting the more success in the latter end of the round early on. Maguire on top. Definitely Sam Boult causing more damage while he was on the ground with those little shots, but nothing significant, but definitely controlling the fight. This is really a battle. If you're going to be on the feet, either man could take it. We could see what's going to happen. If it's going to be on the ground, it's whoever's on top. Yep. They both have a variation of attacks from the bottom. John's got a very good triangle choke, and obviously the Kimura, or the Jamura, as we like to call it, because he's got it so many times. But that he's much more effective from the top position, as is Sam Boult. So it really comes down to who gets the takedown or the reversal and who's on top. And
the position is what really plays a part in maybe how this fight will play out. So if you're in the corner of John Maguire, are you looking for him to get the takedown, maybe initiate that rather than let Sam Boult come forward and
exactly.
do that?
Exactly. He needs to go first and initiate the attacks. And he can't allow it there when he's on the bottom of the bat. He can't be so relaxed. You've got two rounds left to now clasp this fight, because I feel like Sam probably took that first round.
And Sam looking very confident, in exquisite shape as always. An absolute specimen of a human. Great work ethic and also one of the nicest guys you could ever meet outside the cage. Now looking to inch forward, watch him look for that takedown. I'm sure he'll be dropping levels trying to get that against the cage.
Especially with Maguire up against the cage here. Maguire's got great hands, but he has to throw them, has to go first in these positions. Can't just wait for Sam to go to work and look for that takedown.
Oh, some fancy kicks coming there from Sam Boult, expressing himself. And that's one of the things with Boult, it's a lot of mental stuff in there. Is when he switches on, when he's feeling confident, which I'm sure he will be after that first round, that's when he loosens up. But Maguire, good head movement. His striking is underrated, I feel.
100%. Maguire has fantastic boxing, moves very well, fast hands, works over with Steve Whitwell at St. Ives Boxing Academy, and I've been there, and there's great coaching and great boxing there, but he has to use it, has to throw his shots. Sam Boult looking for the takedown. Maguire reverses and gets on top.
Well, this is interesting.
Slight mistake there from Boult, shifting his weight incorrectly, and now let's see if Maguire can pass into the side control position. See if Sam Boult, he's trying to edge back towards that cage. Maguire is very, very tough on top. Like when he has this position, he's got so many attacks and little tricks.
And that is a key moment in this fight. Sam Boult now on bottom. He had that first round on top.
Great shoulder pressure here from Maguire, trying to use that to maybe pass into the mount or the half. Needs to watch for the lockdown of Sam Boult. See how he's triangling his legs, trying to look under. Trying to get, now he looks for the lockdown. Maguire very aware of it.
And now he's got it. But as you said, good pressure, good top pressure from Maguire here. And when you look at 10th Planet gyms around the world, there's not many better than the ones out there in Vegas as far as bodies on the mat and the level you're going to get out there.
No, he's training with everyone. There's so many UFC veterans going to the gym and training with him and working out. You know, I know he works a lot with Eric Spicely and people like that as well, who have got formidable grappling. But, you know, back here in England is where grassroots is where he learned most of his grappling skills and what the ones. Nice to take the back, but Sam Boult to get up.
Oh, great explosion from Sam Boult there, really. I felt like he needed to do something, and just as I was about to say it, he just exploded, which is what you want to see from your fighter.
Maguire dropping down, looking to get the double leg. Sam Boult trying to deep in to get that guillotine. He's got arm in at the moment. Can't wait here, Maguire. There's shots coming in from Boult. Could switch to elbows off his left side as well. If he gets that arm out, Maguire's in a lot of trouble.
Sam Boult did brilliantly to get back to his feet now, and he's making Maguire work for this. Good grip on there. And he's so strong, Sam Boult. So, so strong. Now Maguire switches to that single. Now the ankle pick, can he get it done?
Lifts it up to get his hands together on that double. Goes, drops down, needs to watch those shots and elbows from Boult in this position. Needs to work here. He can't be settling because he's in a lot of trouble and in a dubious position.
Now working the single yet again, now switching back. And this is grueling stuff for both fighters. Sam Boult trying to avoid this takedown, Maguire pushing against the cage.
Maybe you could see him go for a fireman's carry if he controls that wrist. Get his head high, nice.
Oh, but Boult with the underhooks.
Boult
reverses.
Doing very well, using that physicality to control.
Real good work there from Sam Boult. Patient stuff.
Going into the last minute of the round, Sam Boult landing some knees. The bulk of the work being done by John in this round, but there's been nothing really significant. So it, the last minute, anything could take it. A takedown, a good shot.
We expected to see a lot of grappling between these two. And they really are testing each other.
Manages to turn him, but again makes another error and Maguire gets the takedown and is on top.
Just didn't quite have the grip, almost the sweat let them slip off each other as Boult was trying to do the throw.
Maguire passes, goes back into the side, goes back into the half guard, could have a side choke here as well, maybe. From the corner from Jack, asking for damage, there's only 20 seconds left, needs to make a mark on the round to try and take it. I'd say John's probably done more in this round, Sam probably more in the first, so we're probably going to come down to the third round tie.
Oh, and just as it goes, Sam reverses position. Oh, high-level stuff from these two, but this will go to a third round. What gas have they got left in the tank? And I think you're exactly right. It's all about position, whoever can gain that position. John had two good reversals from attempted takedowns from Sam Boult.
John has a surprising and amazing balance. So he's trying to off-balance him and do these throws, which I'm sure Sam Boult gets success with in the gym. But look at the flat feet of John Maguire. You're never getting those off the ground. He's got flat hobbit's feet, very hard to take down.
You can say that, not me.
If you don't do a driving takedown on him, like off-balance him, twisting, judo, it's very difficult to make that work for you. And it's happened twice in that round, so I'll be surprised if he goes for that again in the third in Sam Boult. You probably should change it up and look for more driving takedowns, or we might see a bit of striking in this third round.
Well, we are set for it to all unfold here in the main event at Cage Steel 23. Me, Brian Lacey, alongside Luke Barnett, calling the action this main event, brought to you by our sponsors Fenwick's. John Maguire, John the One Maguire in the blue corner, Sam the Snake Boult in the red, and let's see who's going to make their mark. And you said we might see some striking.
Nice jab from John. Whenever he goes first, he seems to land quite well. Just needs to be aware, because we know Sam Boult just wants this.
Looking to close and clinch, John circles out. Intriguing fight between these two, difficult to score.
Right in front of us here now in the commentary box, John lands a great left hand, probably the best shot of the fight so far. Bit of a smile from Sam. Mixing it up with a low kick, John get groaning confidence on the feet.
Oh, nice!
He needs to get his back off that fence, because we know this is what Sam wants.
Yeah, nice teep to the body, then he faked with it a second one, then used that to close distance, but John circles out.
You see like Sam's giving up on the takedown attempts now and trying more to maybe a bit of stand up, bossed around a little bit. He is the aggressor now. Nice left hand again, and John steps out and circles. Nice movement.
Sam mixing it up with kicks as well. And again, closing the distance, John circles out. Totally different third round from these two now. Nice jab from John. Look how close they are to each other. We talk about range and phone booth fighting. They are right in each other's grills. Now Sam's got the clinch.
Great work from both men now. Sam probably the aggressor in this round so far, but John landing some great shots.
Oh, knee to the body. The clock is ticking though. Crowd here at the Sheffield Arena.
The corner asking John to try and break and look for some striking, but instead he goes for the clinch. Maybe look for a takedown on the cage here, maybe a leg reap. Hands clasped together by Sam Boult.
Looks like they want him to drop for the single leg. They keep pointing to that right leg of Sam Boult. Sam's got that look at the strength there, just switches it across. Oh, John saying low blow. Neil Hall though, keeping an eye on the action here.
Back and forth here on the cage, nothing really separating them.
We saw a bit of a stalemate between them on the ground, now up against the cage there. Switching position. Sam's now the one pressuring John. Those short knees coming on the inside. Oh, and John trying to time a catch.
Needs to watch that guillotine attempt from Sam Boult, though. Like, we know he's very strong. He's getting deep with that grip. It's right across the neck.
Yeah, you can see that. You can see the muscles across the shoulders there of Sam Boult as he feeds that left arm under the air. But his arm in now. John trying to turn the corner. Great work.
No one can beat that single leg. I'm telling you that now. Worldwide, he can take anyone down with that, especially if they want to go for a guillotine. So great takedown there from John. Might clinch the round if he can stay on top.
You can hear the corner there of Sam Boult saying he needs to get up. Time is ticking.
Looking for that side choke. John is on the left side. You can see him trying to work his head up. There's a minute and a half to go in this fight. It's very close.
Great top position from John. Just staying composed. See Sam again working for that lockdown on the other leg this time.
Can see Neil Hall maybe getting closer to the action, thinking about standing it up. There might not be enough action for him. Although this is, they're going back and forth. This is high level stuff. See that lockdown trying to pass.
Yeah, exactly.
If he can get that knee free, he'll definitely pass.
And there's arm a deep is now side raised
choke.
Up that.
And John has a fantastic side choke. Does it with one hand.
Oh, look at that. The right arm is across. He's close to
tapping. He might have this, you know. I've felt this myself many times. He creates so much pressure, and you can see how his right shoulder is digging in.
Because he's got Sam's right arm trapped across his own.
This is a move that he learned over in Las Vegas as well. He came back with it, you know, with that brown belt he's got from Casey. It's definitely close, but Sam Boult fighting in this position now.
And this is when, if it does go to the judges, you hope they've got an understanding of the grappling game.
Well, John's on top for sure. So John's the one putting the pressure forward. Maybe he's going for a submission, trying to finish the fight. He's the aggressor in this particular situation. Going 10 seconds left.
10 seconds left now, knees to the body.
And we're going to go to a very tight decision, very close. John looking to cause damage.
Wow. Wow, what an interesting chess match between these two.
You know, if you're a high-level MMA fan and you enjoy it.
John Maguire believes he's done enough.
He thinks he got the second and the third. I can't disagree, but I know the second was very close.
Very close, and it's down to what the judges decide.
It was a great fight to watch, and I think both men can be proud because, you know, we've seen some fantastic knockouts, some great, great fights tonight. I mean, we had a few wars. Toledo with a great fight as well, performance with a third round stoppage. Yeah. You know, it's been fantastic, but this is high-level stuff in front of us. It's a bit slower, but it's the little points and the little nuances are fantastic to watch.
Absolutely. This is a true headline fight anywhere. These two coming together. You just look at the grappling pedigrees, what they've done in the sport themselves, the paths they've carved.
I feel like John feels like he's won and Sam's not sure.
Yes, yeah, Sam. He's just saying there was nowhere near, but he couldn't get out of that side choke there. We shall make it official. Let's find out who took it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three incredibly technical rounds of mixed martial arts action, we go to the judges' scorecards. And we have a split decision in favor of your winner. From the red corner, Sam the Snake Boult!
We get the third split decision victory of the evening. Very, very close that fight. Both guys did some amazing work. It's been a fantastic night of martial arts here. We've had boxing, we've had BKB, we've had K1, and we've had all sorts of MMA action. It's been a great night here at the Sheffield Arena. I hope you've enjoyed it.
We thank everybody who's come to support the event. It's been an absolute spectacle from top to bottom. The amateur card earlier on today, right through to the pro card. And Sam Boult taking on John Maguire here tonight in the main event. Taking a decision in Sheffield, his hometown. He said, how did he see the fight finishing? He actually said, with a party in Sheffield.
It's been an absolutely incredible event. Cage Steel here in Sheffield, England. Keep up to date with past and future action at cage-steel.co.uk and follow us on social media. We'll be right back in no time at all here in Sheffield, England for more Cage Steel action.
So there we have Grant Waterman signing us off, and we got to say, for me, Brian Lacey and Luke Barnett, what a a spectacle it's been. What an honour it's been to call the pro card. And Luke, you highlighted a few of the real standouts. Danny Mitchell returning. That was one for me. Just felt the arena come alive. Shayab Youssef claiming that victory. Daniel Jacare Toledo, your main sparring partner, claiming the title here. And then the main event that involves John Maguire and Sam Boult. What a pleasure it's been.
An amazing night of action. So many highlights, it's hard to describe them all. I look forward to the next Cage Steel, and I look forward to calling the fights for you again, bro.
Oh, mate, it's always a pleasure. I think I might have to buy you a beer now. That's
beer time. Beer time.
Listen, thanks for joining us. Thanks for tuning in. Come and keep supporting Cage Steel. I've been Brian Lacey. That's Luke Barnett. We'll see you again.